Welcome to Reality Create a Video. I'm Hermes, and today we're going to cover how to make colloidal gold. Now, in the last show, I showed you how to make colloidal copper. Now, I would like you to refer to that show because there are a lot of things in that show that I went into explicit details on how to make stuff, showed you exactly how to make it. And in this show, to save video time, I am not going to go into I'm not going to show you step by step how to do every little process. I am just going to show you what you need to do to create colloidal gold. So you'll need to reference, I'll put the link to the video in the description to the colloidal copper video. All right. So we're going to make colloidal gold. This is a batch of colloidal gold. I've just cooked it up. We're going to make another batch of colloidal gold. And colloidal gold starts with the gold rod right here. This is a gold rod. This is a twisted gold rod made up of 3 or 4 22 and 24 gauge gold. The reason it's a twisted rod is because, like everybody, I started out with a 22 or 24 gauge piece of gold wire. That's what this is. And after cooking batches of gold, this got way too thin, and I had to buy another piece of gold wire. And didn't want to waste it, so I said, hey, wait, let me just twist the two together, which is what I did. So then I had two twisted pairs of gold wire, and so being I make quite a bit of gold, so now this piece of gold wire here is a bunch of used twisted gold wires all together. The thicker your gold wire, your gold cathode is, the faster it's going to cook. Now, this last batch that I just made cooked in 19 minutes and 14 seconds. It used exactly 0.007 grams, which would be 7 milligrams of material, which then gives us a 14 parts per million gold solution, creating ruby red colloidal gold. And we need the ruby red colloidal gold in order to get that limitless. And if you've watched my previous videos, you'll know me. I go all out on my limitless when I drink the gold, and it boosts my mental processes, and I just want to go and go and go. That is one of the many benefits of gold. It's an anti-inflammatory. It's a health booster. I mean, it all around, colloidal gold is really terrific for the body. Between that and colloidal silver, you got a dynamite combination in those two colloidals there. But making gold is tricky, all right? There are different kinds of gold. There is ruby red colloidal gold. There is orange colloidal gold. And there is purple colloidal gold. Now, the only gold that works really, really great and gets your bang for the buck on the amount of gold material you're going to use is absolute ruby red gold. So, and in order to get absolute ruby red gold, you have to follow the formula precisely. Because if you don't follow this formula precisely, you're not going to get ruby red colloidal gold. You'll get orange. You might get purple. Purple, right? Oh, you might even, if you even go too far, you might get what I call the dreaded gray colloidal gold, which means if you used a 24-gauge colloidal gold rod, you've now burned up 50% of your gold rod if your solution goes gray. So please follow the directions very, very closely, because otherwise you will be wasting gold. And gold, the gold rods I get on Amazon, they have to be 24 carat gold rod. 14 does not work. You can use a 24 karat gold coin too, if you happen to have one of those hanging around. I use the wire. Roughly a 24 gauge wire will last you about 60 batches of 500 milliliters of colloidal gold. You'll get more out of that but it'll become too thin, and you'll have to buy another piece and twist it together like I've done here. Now let's talk about the anode. The anode supplies the electrons which blast off the gold from the cathode. Now you can use a gold anode or you can use a copper anode. Traditionally, people use a copper anode because it's cheaper. I've tried both. To be perfectly honest, copper anode is much more efficient than the gold anode. It takes a lot longer when I use a gold anode. So, much prefer the efficiency of the larger 12-gauge copper anode to the smaller, inefficient 22-gauge gold anode. But you can use a gold anode if you want. We're going to use copper. The next part of the process is making the stock solutions to create the colloidal gold. We have to add certain chemicals in here to get what the proper gold that we want. So, and those chemicals are kitchen household friendly chemicals, sodium citrate, NaCl or sea salt. Also, you can use table salt. No iodine. Do not get salt with iodine. And corn syrup. So, we can't use these things in their straight form because it's too hard to get a precise dosage into the solution. So we're going to make stock solutions. You can review the colloidal copper video on making stock solutions. I'm just going to go through it quickly here. In the corn syrup, you're going to take 30 milliliters of this corn syrup, and you're going to mix it with 20 milliliters of distilled water. And then you're going to mix that all together and put that in an eyedropper bottle like this. And basically, we do this so that we can actually use an eyedropper with it, because this stuff is so thick, you're not using an eyedropper with that. We're going to mix, let's just check my plan here. We're going to mix 1.5 grams of salt in 500 milliliters of water, distilled water. And then you're going to mix 7.35 grams of sodium citrate in 500 milliliters of distilled water. You can use your kitchen scale to measure those out. If you got it, you will need a kitchen scale to measure those amounts of powders out in the right amount. You won't need a three-digit scale to measure the powders out. The two-digit scale will be fine enough for measuring the amount of your ingredients. And after that's done, then we get to the water. All right. Now, save time, I have preheated this water in the microwave to get me most of the way to where it needs to be. We have to heat this water to 90 degrees C. Right now I got it at 81, but this is the next part of this process. We're going to put in the probe. Oh, wait a minute. First we're going to put the stirrer in there. Keep the stirrer going. All right, then we're going to put in the temperature probe. Now this temperature probe is coated. I have this temperature probe coated with vinyl sleeving. The vinyl sleeving is very important. You can't have any kind of metal in a gold process whatsoever, or it's going to interfere. So the temperature probe, which locks the temperature in on my gold machine here, my heating stirrer, I have a vinyl tube on there to isolate it so that the metal is not in the water. So this is a infrared laser, which tells me the temperature of the water, which right now, well, it's at 80 degrees C, needs to be 90. And this is a heated stirrer, so it will heat the water up. But in the meantime, While it's doing that, we need to put our chemicals in here. All right, so let's get to doing that. All right, first we're going to do corn syrup. We're going to put 8 drops of corn syrup in here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, we're going to put 8 drops in there, corn syrup. Next, we're going to put 40 milliliters of NaCl. Okay, that is 40 milliliters of NaCl. I got my little handy dandy funnel here. Make sure it all goes in there. All right. Next, we're going to put 10 milliliters of sodium citrate. Course, we get stuff like that happening. So that's what we got pipettes for. We just suck out what we don't want. 10 milliliters. And we dump that in carefully. Next, you want to, if you have colloidal gold, you will add 10 milliliters of colloidal gold to kickstart the process. It makes it go a little faster. If you don't have colloidal gold, then don't use anything. Don't worry about it. It's just going to take a little bit longer to reach the desired color of ruby red. And you don't have to actually worry about weighing the rod. I weigh it afterwards to see how much I've got in there, make sure that I'm on track. But it's really going to be determined by the color. This is the color that we want, this deep ruby red color. When you reach that deep ruby red color, you stop the process. The water has reached 90 degrees C and we're ready to start. I'm going to put in my copper anode. And hook that up. I'm going to put in my gold cathode. Hook that up. And then we're going to, let me activate the power supply up here. Now the power supply, as you can see, we're at 9 minutes and it's starting to develop some color. Now on the power supply, I wanted to mention that you will need, I recommend between a 30 and 40 volt power supply that can supply 1,000 milliamps. Typically, your gold process with a 500 milliliter jar is going to be 300 milliamps. If you're making a larger batch of gold, it'll be more. So that's the minimum that I recommend. We are now at 16 minutes, well, 17 minutes, and you can see the color is still continuing to develop. We're going to let it go. I got to let it go. It's not really at the color yet, but we're getting there. Welcome back. The process is done. It took 27 minutes and 45 seconds. I've measured the rod and we've used between 0.006 and 0.007 6 or 7 milligrams of material came off of here to create ruby red. And that's it. In the microscope, I put it in the microscope and you can see it. You can see it right here. This is what it looks like, which is a typical it's typically what the gold looks like in the video microscope. So that's how you do your create your absolute ruby red colloidal gold. I'm Hermes. This is Reality Creative Video, and I will talk to you again soon.